If you go to help and if you click on Python docs, it opens for you the docs. And in the documentation, I told you go to library reference. And in the library reference, you have something called as the built-in functions. When you go to built-in functions, you have, let me just have a look. You have something called as ID. Can you see ID? So if I click on ID, it requires, okay, it says put an object, returns the identity of an object. Okay, so is it possible? Yes, let's say ID of A. ID of A, that means this is a function again, as I told you, explained to you last time. You can call a function multiple times and you need to pass something called as a parameter or you need to pass an argument. So I'm passing now an object, that is A. I'm passing a reference, I'm passing that. ID of A is 144177400. For you, it may be a different number, because it may be pointing your value 25 may be put into some other memory location having a different address. But what about ID of B? Oh, it is same as that of the ID of A. Of course. Why is it so? Because both of them are now pointing to the same object, same integer object as the other. Hope you are able to understand this particular concept where you have the ID of A and the ID of B. So this is where you can say that and B are references to the same object, are references to the same object. Okay, sir, you are using this term object constantly. Okay, what is the meaning of an object? An object is nothing but of a particular type. Okay, say for example, 25 is always an integer. Okay, 25 is always an integer. 42 is always an integer. You can say what type it is. Okay, if you can say what type it is, it means it is an object of that particular type or of that particular class. Okay, now say for example in a particular college, let's say an engineering college, or let's say BCom or any other college, a degree college, in a college there are different identities, there are different people having different identities. What kind of people come there? First of all, you have something called a student. So you have a student coming there. So not just one, but there are many students. So each of those students are going to belong to a particular class called as student class. Okay, so you have a student class and you have all the boys and girls coming there under that type of student. But is student the only class? No, you might have some other class of teachers, you might have some other class of office staff. Okay, so you have different classes, and objects are nothing but derived versions of those classes. Hope you are able to understand with me. Okay, if you are able to understand this, can I say something like this? Can I say A and B are nothing but objects of which class? Integer class. They are objects of integer class. They are always integer. Sir, can you prove it to me that these are integer class? I didn't specify over here somewhere saying integer. I didn't specify over here also that it's an integer. But can you specify it to me? In other programming languages, it was already said integer. But how can you prove that it is an integer? I can see it with something. Again, go back to your documentation. In the documentation, I can go back to my built-in functions. In my built-in functions, can I see something called as a type, a function called as type? When I click on type, it says pass me an object. I pass an object. What is an object? I say over there type of A. If I say type of A and I say enter, what does it say? Class int. It is a type of A. It is of class integer. Okay, so can I say type of B is also going to be class int? Yes, it is. Okay, so now if I say A is, now in other programming languages you can't do this. Once you have defined A as 25, You can't define it as a is equal to 3.5. No. Other programming languages will throw you an error. Why? Why? Because you can't change the data type of a particular variable. But in Python, a is not a container which can contain only one particular type of a particular data. No. A is a reference, which means A can at one time point to one memory location, and at another time you can change the reference of A. You can change the pointing of A to another location. It doesn't matter. Okay, so when you say A is equal to 3.5, you know what happens? This particular reference where A was pointing to this object 25, that gets cancelled out. A no longer points to 25, which is a reference to the particular object. No. A does not point to 25, but A now points to another object 3.5. But what is the type of this 3.5? This is an object of which class? If I say type of A, it says class float. Are you able to understand with me? Yes, it is type class float. Okay, so that means can A be something like alphabets? Can I just say alphabets? Let's say alphabets like I can say hi, and then I say, and then I in double quote, and then I say yes. Okay, so what is the type of A? What is the type of A? It says class str. Wow, it means it is a string. It is a string. It means in Python, you do not need to specify. You do not need to specify which class does it belong to. Hope you are with me up till now on this. Hope you understand whatever I said with respect to this. So you have something called as variables. You can define variables each, and you can change the data of the variables, because A is nothing but a reference to this particular object. These objects are nothing but of a particular class. It can be either an integer, float, string, and some more. Let's say A can also be something called as, it can, if I say true with a capital T. Okay, and if I say what is the type of A, it says class bool, which means what? A is having a particular type, that is either it is true or it is false. It is a boolean value. It can be either a 0 or a 1. It cannot be anything other than that. Okay, so this is where you can define a variable of different types. We just saw two main functions up till now. The first function that we saw was print. Also, we saw three: print, and then we saw ID, and then we saw type. So we saw three functions. Okay, hope you will practice them out. And we saw a few data types, a few primitive data types which are already there. Okay, so the data types that we saw, the data types that we just went through quickly are int, then we saw was float, and then we saw string, and we saw boolean. Yes, hope you are on the same page up till now.